Well, God bless you and welcome to Real People, Real Voices. I'm your host, James Jackson.
I'm your co-host, Pastor Wayne Moore.
Always a pleasure to host with you.
It is. It's good to see you again today, man. You doing well?
I'm doing well. Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Yeah, happy to be in your presence and happy to be with Real People, Real Voices once again by virtual viewing. That's a great job. They're doing a great job in the studio.
It's certainly different than what we're used to.
Yeah, it is very different. But, you know, we seem to be adjusting pretty good. We're hanging in there, and that's what we need to do, hang in there.
Everybody needs to hang in there, and especially our children going back to school, a whole lot of things going on with that. Mm-hmm. Speaking of school, we've got a great guest coming up, Dr. Huddleston, president of Martin University. He'll be joining us here in just a little bit.
Yeah, can't wait to talk to him. Just so happy that Martin is moving in a positive direction, even in COVID-19.
Absolutely. And we got some sponsors we want to thank.
Yes, we want to thank Lee Kossel and Crawley for being one of our sponsors. Fervent Care Christian Academy. Make sure you get your child enrolled when it opens, if it is open. And not only that, Isles Modern Clothing and Shoes. And we save the best for last. The Marion County Public Health Department, who is doing an outstanding work and job in our communities to combat COVID-19.
Yeah, helping to mitigate those, mitigate the spread of COVID-19.
That's right. That's
keeping the numbers down, and the deaths has been under 1%, which has been phenomenal for a large city.
Yeah, not too bad, but we still have a rise in certain areas in which some people and some areas of business are still apprehensive about moving in some directions. But we're going to be praying that the Lord will help us get through this.
Certainly, I want to make sure everyone knows you can watch this show when it's over, as well as others that you might have missed on WHMB TV 40 YouTube channel, and also like us on
Facebook. We're there. We've been there since the inception of this show. We thank God that we have established a format to where we are here every week to try to make sure people understand what's going on religiously as well as in our communities.
All right. So stay with us. We thank God for you. We'll be back in just a few moments with our first guest, Dr. Huddleston. Welcome back to Real People, Real Voices. I'm your host, James Jackson.
Your co-host, Pastor Wayne Moore.
And joining us is Dr. Sean Huddleston, president of Martin University. Good to see you again.
Great to see you both.
Thank you. And a wonderful time.
Go ahead, Jackson. I'm sorry.
A wonderful time with you last year with the Giblethon.
Yeah, a historic day for Martin University. We raised a lot of money that day. Thanks to both of you. We shattered our goal, if you recall.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, I want to thank all those who are watching who gave during that period of time. We really, really appreciate it. And I know that Dr. Huddleston and the team over at Martin appreciates it as well. How are things going? How are you all acclimating to everything that's been going on with COVID-19?
Yeah, you know, it's been, thank you for asking and for having me on the show today. You know, like most higher education institutions, it's been a bit challenging, but we seem to be weathering it quite well. We intend to have an opening this fall. In fact, our classes start week after next, and we're going to be offering our classes in what we're calling a high flex format. It's a little bit different than hybrid, which is a blended format of in-person and online. In HyFlex, you can attend class really any way you want. You can come face-to-face, or you can come completely online, or anything between the two, because we recognize that many of our students and prospective students have challenges that they need to overcome with things like children at home because of COVID-19 not being able to go to school. Some other challenges they may have. And so we want to make sure that it's they're able to get their education their way. And so we want to be as flexible as possible. We actually have a express registration event tomorrow here on our campus where anybody interested in starting school or coming back and register for school can come right through the parking lot and kind of a socially distanced way and get registered for school. So we're excited about that. We also have our commencement coming up on Saturday, where we're able to honor our 2020 graduates. And we thought it was important that we still have a face-to-face commencement to honor these folks after these huge journeys that they've been through and in what they have been able to accomplish.
I think that's phenomenal in spite of what we're going through in the city of Indianapolis and all over the country, that you have designed it to where it could work for those graduates. I think they're going to really appreciate that. Just stay safe. I want you to stay safe because you're an intricate part of this city and a viable key to that school. So you stay safe as you do the commencement with those students. And I'm pretty sure they're going to appreciate that.
Dr. Huddleston, I don't think I'm precipitous to say that Martin is a predominantly African-American university. And certainly there's a lot going on with regard with racial equity and inclusion. How are you all in addressing that?
Yeah, you know, we really, when the George Floyd murder happened and all of the civil and social unrest occurred because we just got tired of this continuously happening around our country. As Martin University, we decided that we wanted to do more than just issue a statement or have words. We needed to do something that brought about action, but do it from a place of education. And so we decided to launch a Center for Racial Equity and Inclusion. And we think that does a couple of things. Number one, we wanted to make sure that those who are there to be able to provide opportunities for African Americans also have sustainable practices that ensure not just that Black people can be invited into their businesses or into their employment, but also have an opportunity to thrive there. And so we want to make sure that they recognize that there is a real intentional way about doing that. So we're offering training for that. We also know that we needed to reach into our community and make sure that we, as a people, are connecting with each other and finding ways to be able to not just stabilize our lives, but grow and not have to worry about our mortality. And so we hear about Black Lives Matter, and they absolutely do. It is about us making sure that we can stay alive in this country and be free. But equally important, in my opinion, as Black Lives Matter, is Black livelihood matters as well. And so we want to make sure that we're creating the opportunities and the trajectory for our people to be able to live the types of lives that they want to live. And so we're connecting each other with each other to be able to do that. We're going to have an initiative that's focused on men of color, particularly Black males, called Brother to Brother, where we find a way to network with each other, but also support each other and connect in and out, out into the community. Mm-hmm. We want to connect organizations and churches and other individuals who really want to make a difference, who want to help to increase and expand our ability to depend on ourselves to be able to uplift our communities. And so that's what that center is really going to be about. And so we're seeing a lot of positive response to the Center for Racial Equity and Inclusion. We've got a number of organizations that are kind of lining up and saying that they want to be a part of it and certainly want to either be a client of the center or a partner of the center in some way. And so we're excited about that. We're still in the planning stages, but we expect the full launch to occur around the first of the year in 2021.
It's going to be phenomenal. Look forward to hearing more about that as it gets rolling. And hopefully that it will be effective and serve as a tool in the community.
We hope so.
And Dr. Huddleston, you said Black livelihood, which is not something that we have been hearing, but it is very, very important. And speaking of livelihood, with regard to Black folks who live in Indianapolis, I was going over the Thrive Indianapolis plan. Mm-hmm. course, familiar with a lot of this as well. And very concerning to me that of all the ethnic groups mentioned in that plan, that Black families are last in median household income. Black families are also last when it comes to employment. And we're leading the numbers, as I understand it, with regard to homicide. So I think when we start talking about Black livelihood, is this something that your initiative will kind of touch on and hopefully be a place where we can monitor and measure our progress?
Yes, as a matter of fact, we're actually ushering in a completely new model at the university that's focused on addressing those things that you just talked about. You know, I've said a number of times that we are first in the worst categories and last in the best categories. And so we're launching a new model for the university that really integrates workforce development and entrepreneurship into our academic programs. It's going to be called the Martin Works Initiative, but it's modeled off of the Urban Work College that was pioneered by Paul Quinn College down in Dallas, Texas. And essentially what we're doing is we're partnering with employers and we're asking them to do a couple things. First is to give internships, externships, or other experiential learning opportunities that are paid to our students so that what they're learning in class, they can actually apply in their area of expertise or area of study in a real job, right? And so these are not hourly positions or positions that would not require a college degree eventually. These are positions that really lead to stable and growing careers and high-paying careers. So that's one thing. The second thing we've asked them to do is to partner with us on developing the curriculum so that what we're teaching our students in class are things that they actually can apply when they graduate. So that the goal at Martin University is not just to graduate with a degree, but graduate with a degree that you can do something with. And then help you do something with that degree through the partnerships. And so we've got some pretty strong employer partners that have already stepped to the table, and we're in conversations with a few more. So we're really, really excited about that. But that's going to be the new pathway for Martin University. We'll launch a pilot in 2021 and then expand that approach out in 2022 and beyond.
All right, we're going to have to sit here and pick it up and talk with Dr. Huddle. And we'll be back after this. Welcome back to our very special interview with Dr. Sean Huddleston. Again, always a pleasure to have you on the show with us.
My pleasure.
I think that you perhaps were talking about Martin Works there a little bit without our explicitly saying Martin Works. But if you could say more about that initiative, please do.
Yeah, sure. So what it will comprise of is students will have a work experience, an academic experience, obviously, but then also be responsible for community service. And so in a given semester, a student will have anywhere from 8 to 15 hours a week that they would work at one of the assignments that we've set up for them. They'd be paid a rate that would be consistent with the entry-level salary of that particular industry or that position. So let's say if you are an IT professional, as we know, that's a higher paying position that would probably have a higher hourly rate for the work. But certainly we're looking at addictions counseling, anyone who wants to be a mental health professional, anyone who wants to be an IT professional or any other business related discipline. Those are the four that we're starting with in our pilot. And so they would attend classes as normal. We would integrate the 8 to 15 week internship, if you will. And then over the course of the semester or 16 weeks, we'd ask them to complete about 40 hours of community service that could occur in their church or in partnership with a community organization. We'll also have community service activities associated with the university through partnerships that we have, that they'd be able to get those hours in. And then when they graduate with an academic transcript and a work transcript. The work transcript could be converted to a resume. And hopefully through the assignments and through the interactions that they have with their employers, when they graduate, they get an academic transcript, a work transcript, and hopefully an offer letter too. And so that's what we want them to have when they walk across that stage. We also will have, about a year after the pilot, we'll bring in an entrepreneurship track so that we'll help people become their own bosses and put themselves in a position to hire others.
Let me comment on that as it relates to the tracks that you're going to offer in the Martin Works approach. You know, there are billions of dollars that are going to be spent in a 100-acre radius on the west side of Indianapolis. And most of that is going to be technology and the health field. Yeah. You did mention IT, I believe.
Yes.
But what are you doing as it relates to possibly equip people to meet the demand that the 16 Tech and the IU campus is going to be needing in the future, along with a lot of other development in that area? That's a 100-acre area of economic development, which will probably be in excess of $3 to $4 billion. What do you think about that?
Yeah, so business and information technology are two of the areas that we are strongly focused on, and we'll have several tracks as it relates to both. So on the information technology side, we'll have everything from database administration to network security, cybersecurity, things of that nature, and through stackable credentials. So students will have an opportunity to achieve certificates as they're earning their college degrees, which, as you well know, just continues to bolster their earning potential in those particular fields. On the health side, we're focused right now on behavioral health. Our two biggest programs at the undergraduate level is our psychology and addictions counseling program. And then our biggest graduate program is our community psychology program, which leads to a licensure track. And so we have, in conversations with one of our partners, Eskenazi Health, we found that there is a strong need in behavioral health. We also are partnering with the Department of Corrections, who is hiring, and they're looking for people to work in the counseling, addictions counseling, and the behavioral health professions as well. Those are native programs to Martin University, so we thought that was the best place for us to start. We do plan to grow into other healthcare fields, but we don't have those programs at the university yet, so we'll have to get to the point that we're adding those. But we do know where we do have the programs and where we're good. And so when we selected the programs from Martin Works, we actually looked at the hot jobs. So we looked at the Department of Workforce Development, where the careers are expanding. We talked to the economic development folks in the state to find out what's coming and how we can prepare our students. And so that's the plan. We absolutely want to make sure we're taking advantage. But the key for us, being a predominantly Black institution, is those organizations and those initiatives ought to include some level of racial diversity. And when they include that level of racial diversity, ought to make sure that when those employees come, that they have an opportunity to grow their careers while they're involved or they're there. And so we think that's equally as important.
Okay.
Outstanding. And we have about 2 minutes left, Dr. Huddleston. You're the fifth president
of
Martin University. Don't know that you're the first one to lead through a pandemic, but how's it going with you having to have this responsibility at such a critical time?
Well, they don't teach you crisis management in president school. I can tell you that one for sure. You know, I think, quite frankly, I'm learning the way that you all, that we're all learning at the same time. We are in conversations fairly regularly with Dr. Kane at the Marion County of the Marion County Department of Health to make sure that we are doing all the right things that we can. But more than anything else, pastors, I'm trying to educate myself and stay safe, obviously. But educate myself as well as I can. The commencement's going to be outside, for example. And we're going to have social distance through that. We've got a tent in case it rains. And we're not allowing a large crowd. People will be able to live stream it or watch it from the parking lot. But we're learning as we go.
Well, we haven't abandoned. We have not abandoned the telethon or the giveathon.
We have not. No, we have not.
We still need that 250,000.
That's right.
So we got to get going with that. And I just want to keep us reminded that we're working in that, and it'll probably be a virtual type of situation. So we're gonna have to get going on that.
Yeah, you know, we didn't think, or folks didn't think we could raise 100,000, and we did that last year. So I think 250 is doable.
Yeah, you know, you got to always talk about something that people that gives us an ability to reach forward. So that's where we are.
And certainly money can be transmitted virtually.
Yes, it can. Well, hallelujah.
Thank you, Dr. Huddleston. Always
thank
a pleasure.
You, Doc.
My pleasure. Thank you all. God bless you both.
God bless you.
Yeah, thank you.
We'll be back after this. Welcome back to Real People, Real Voices. I'm your host, James Jackson.
Co-host, Pastor Wayne Moore.
And I'm Curtis Baker from TV 40.
Well, good evening, gentlemen, and good to have you all on the wrap-up. Great show there. We probably have just enough time to thank our sponsors.
Yeah, Lee Castle and Crawley and Fervent Care Christian Academy, Al's Modern Clothing and Shoes, and the Marion County Public Health Department, who's been helping us stay safe.
Just want to give you guys a little tip, you know, our audience, that be on the lookout this coming December the 5th. We will be back with the Martin University TV 40 Giveathon, and it's going to be great. It's going to be virtual, but we'll also do some live stuff as well. So it's going to be different. So you got to stay tuned and watch it, guys.
And you know, Curtis, this is a good time for business owners who are trying to get things back online to give you a call and talk about sponsoring the Giveathon.
Yeah, that would be a great time for them to do that. This is that time.
I love that idea. Just give me a call at the station right here at the station. What is the phone number here? I should know that. I didn't want to give my personal phone number out, but the number here is 317-703-1946. That's 317-703-1946. Call me, we'll get you on Real People, Real Voices as a sponsor, and you will be a big business boom success.
We'll let that be the last word. We'll see you.
That is the last word.